We will continue exercise 1.1 relations and functions, chapter 1 relations and functions, exercise 1.1. In previous video we learned different types of relations. We learned empty relation, universal relation, then we learned equivalence relation, reflexive, symmetric, transitive. If a relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, then it is called equivalence relation. So now we are going to do some questions from exercise 1.1. Question number 2. Show that the relation R in the set R of real numbers. So here the given set is set of real numbers. Set of real numbers. So that is the given set. And the relation defined in the set. That relation is, here it is capital letter R, this is set of real numbers, and here this R represents relation. So here R is given, set of all ordered pair AB such that A less than or equal to B square. We need to show is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. So we have to show that this relation is neither reflexive nor symmetric and nor transitive. So here that relation defined in the set of real numbers. So for reflexive, if it is a reflexive, then when we take any real number A from set of real numbers, when we take any real number A, then ordered pair AA belongs to R. If ordered pair AA belongs to R, for every A belongs to set of real numbers, then it is reflexive. So we can take one example. 1 by 2 is a real number, but 1 by 2 is not less than or equal to 1 by 2 square. If A less than or equal to B square, then AB belongs to R. 1 by 2 is not less than or equal to 1 by 2 square because 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4. So 1 by 2 is not less than or equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2 does not belongs to set of real numbers. So when we take 1 by 2, a real number 1 by 2, then ordered pair 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belongs to, sorry, here 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belongs to this relation. But 1 by 2 is a real number. Ordered pair 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belong to R. So we can say that it is not reflexive. Because ordered pair 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belong to this relation, but 1 by 2 is a real number. But when we take whole numbers or integers, when we take integers, it is satisfied. 2 less than or equal to 2 square. So ordered pair 2, 2 belongs to R. Or minus 3 less than or equal to minus 3 square. So minus 3 comma minus 3 belongs to R. But when we take fractions, that relation is not satisfied here. So in the case of fractions, it is not satisfied. But in the case of integers, it is satisfied. So it is not a reflexive. So in this example, in fractions, ordered pair 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belong to R. So it's not a reflexive. Therefore, it is not a reflexive. Then for symmetric, we can take one example. 2 less than or equal to 5 square. If A less than or equal to B square, then ordered pair AB belongs to R. 2 less than or equal to 5 square, therefore ordered pair 2, 5 belongs to relation. But 5 is not less than or equal to 2 square. 2 square is 4. 5 is not less than or equal to 4. Therefore 5 comma 2 does not belongs to R. So here 2, 5 belongs to R, but 5, 2 does not belongs to R. Therefore it is not a symmetric. If it is symmetric, AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R for every A comma B belongs to set of real numbers. But in this case 2 and 5 are two real numbers. 2 less than or equal to 5 square, but 5 not less than or equal to 2 square. So 2, 5, ordered where 2, 5 belongs to R, but ordered where 5, 2 does not belong to R, therefore it is not symmetric. Then for transitive, 3 less than or equal to minus 2 square. 3 less than or equal to minus 2 square, that is 3 less than or equal to 4. Therefore, ordered where 3 comma minus 2 belongs to this relation. And minus 2 less than or equal to minus 1 square. That is minus 2 less than or equal to minus 1 square is 1. So minus 2 less than or equal to 1. Therefore, minus 2 comma minus 1 belongs to R. If A less than or equal to B square, then ordered where AB belongs to R. Similarly, minus 2 less than or equal to minus 1 square, therefore ordered where minus 2 minus 1 belongs to R. But 3, ordered where 3 minus 2 belongs to R, minus 2 minus 1 belongs to R, but 3 comma minus 1, 3 is not less than or equal to minus 1 square. Because 3 minus 1 square is 1, 3 less than or equal to 1, that is wrong. Therefore, 3 comma minus 1 does not belong to R. So here, if it is transitive, if AB and BC belongs to R, if ordered where AB and ordered where BC belongs to R, then ordered where AC should be an element of R. But here, 3 comma minus 2 belongs to R, minus 2 comma minus 1 belongs to R, but 3 comma minus 1, ordered where 3 comma minus 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not a transitive. So here, this relation is not reflexive, it's not symmetric, and it is not transitive. So that is question number 2. Now we are going to do question number, we can do third question. Check whether the relation R defined on the set. Third one, A is given. Set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is given that R is equal to ordered where AB such that B equal to A plus 1. We need to show that it is reflexive, symmetric. We need to check whether it is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. So first we can write the elements of that set. So that is the relation B equal to A plus 1. So when A is equal to 1, B equal to 1 plus 1. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. So 1, 2. Then when A is equal to 2, then 2, 3. Then 3, 4. Then 4, 5. Then 5, 6. And when we take A is equal to 6, then B is equal to 6 plus 1, 7, but 7 is not an element. Therefore, this is the relation. So these are the elements of R. Now we have to check whether it is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. It is not reflexive because ordered where 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6 are not belongs to R. So it is not reflexive. For reflexive, 1 belongs to A. 1 is an element of A, but ordered where 1, 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not reflexive. Then, for symmetric, one, two belongs to R, but 2, 1 does not belong to R. Ordered where 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2, 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not symmetric. Then transitive. 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R. Then 1, 3 should be an element. But 1, 3 is not an element of R. So for transitive, 1, 2, ordered where 1, 2 belongs to R and ordered where 2, 3 belongs to R, but ordered where 1, 3 does not belong to R, therefore it is not transitive. So transitive property, if AB and BC belongs to R, then ordered where AC should be an element of R, so here it's not transitive. Now we can do fourth question. Show that the relation R in set of real numbers defined by ordered pair AB such that A less than or equal to B is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. It's easy question, you can do by yourself. Now we will do question number 5. Check whether the relation R in set of real numbers, given set of real numbers, set of real numbers, and here the relation R is equal to ordered where AB such that A less than or equal to B cube. We need to check whether it is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. Reflexive, symmetric or transitive. So here for reflexive, we can take one example, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is not less than or equal to 1 by 2 cube. 1 by 2 is not less than or equal to 1 by 2 raised to the power 3. If A less than or equal to B cube, then ordered where AB belongs to R. Here, 1 by 2 not less than or equal to 1 by 2 cube. Therefore, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2, ordered where 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2 does not belongs to R, but 1 by 2 belongs to set of real number. 1 by 2 is a real number, but ordered where 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belongs to this relation, therefore it is not reflexive. It is not a reflexive. That property is not satisfying. If ordered where AA belongs to R, for every A belongs to R, set of real numbers, so here not satisfied, it's not reflexive. Then for symmetric, we can take 1 and 2. 1 less than or equal to 2 cube, therefore ordered where 1, 2 belongs to R. 1 less than or equal to 2 cube, therefore ordered where 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2 is not less than or equal to 1 cube, therefore ordered where 2, 1 does not belongs to R, therefore R is not symmetric. R is not symmetric. Then transitive. So here transitive, it is not a transitive. We can contradict the transitive property by taking some example. Transitive. Here 100 less than or equal to 5 cube. 5 cube is 125, so 100 less than or equal to 125. If 100 less than or equal to 5 cube, therefore 100 comma 5 belongs to that relation. Then 5 less than or equal to 2 cube. 2 cube is 8, 5 less than or equal to 8, therefore ordered where 5, 2 belongs to R. Ordered where 100, 5 belongs to R. Ordered where 5, 2 belongs to R. And if it is transitive, then ordered where 100, 2. Here 100, 5 belongs to R. 5, 2 belongs to R. Then if 100, 2, if ordered where 100, 2 belongs to R, then it is transitive. But 100 not less than or equal to 2 cube. 2 cube is 8. 2 cube is 8. 100 is not less than or equal to 2 cube. Therefore, 100 comma 2 does not belongs to R. So here, transitive property is not satisfying. First pair is there, second pair is there, but the third pair, 100 comma 5 belongs to R, 5 comma 2 belongs to R, but 100 comma 2 does not belong to R, therefore it is not transitive. So this relation is not reflexive, not symmetric, and it is not transitive. Now we will do question number 6 and 7. You can do by yourself. Now we can do question number 8. 8 and 9 almost the same. I will explain 8th question and you will do a 9th question by yourself. 8th one. Show that the relation R in the set A. A is given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Given by the relation R is given. Set of all ordered where AB such that A minus B, modulus of A minus B is even number. So that is the relation. Is an equivalence relation. That means we need to show that it is a reflexive, symmetric and a transitive. Then we can say that it is equivalence relation. Then we have one more part. Show that all the elements of set 1, 3, 5 are related to each other and all the elements of set 2, 4 are related to each other, but no element of set 1, 3, 5 is related to any element of set 2, 4. So first we can do first part. We need to show that it is equivalence relation. That means we are going to show it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. For reflexive, A minus A, modulus of A minus A equal to 0 is an even number. Therefore, ordered where AA belongs to R for every A belongs to, for every A belongs to set A. So here, when we take any element here, 1 minus 1, 0. 0 is an even number. So, ordered where 1 belongs to R. Modulus of 1 minus 1, that is 0, even number. Similarly, modulus of 2 minus 2, even number. So, ordered where 2 belongs to R. Ordered where 3 belongs to R. 4 belongs to R. 5 belongs to R. Reason, their difference is an even number. So, ordered where AA belongs to R, for every A belongs to A. Therefore, R is reflexive. Therefore, R is reflexive. Then for symmetric, we can do this one by taking the elements of R, like that also we can do, but here we are not writing the elements here. For symmetric, let AB belongs to R. Let AB belongs to R. If BA belongs to R, then we can say that it is reflexive. Sorry, symmetric. AB belongs to R. Implies, if AB belongs to R, then modulus of A minus B is even number. Modulus of A minus B is even. That is the definition of relation. Implies, if modulus of A minus B is even, then modulus of minus of A minus B. Modulus of A minus B, that is minus of B minus A. Minus of B minus A is A minus B. So minus of B minus B is even. Because both of them are same. That is modulus of minus B by A and modulus of minus of B minus A and modulus of B minus A, both are same, is even number. If modulus of B minus A is even, if modulus of A minus B is even, ordered where AB belongs to R. If modulus of B minus A is even, ordered where BA belongs to R. So here, AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R for every A, B belongs to A. That is, AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R for every A B belongs to A. Therefore, R is symmetric. R is symmetric. Now we have to prove it is transitive. For transitive, let ordered where AB belongs to R and ordered where BC belongs to R. If ordered where AB belongs to R, modulus of A minus B is even number, and ordered where BC belongs to R, that means modulus of B minus C is even number. That is modulus of A minus B and modulus of B minus C are even numbers. Modulus of A minus B and the modulus of B minus C are even numbers. If modulus of A minus B is even number, then we can say A minus B and B minus C are even numbers. A minus B and B minus C are even numbers. Sum of two even numbers is again an even number. So A minus B plus B minus C is an even number. A minus B plus B minus C, that is A minus, minus B and plus B cancelled, A minus C is an even number. If A minus C is an even number, then modulus of A minus C, then modulus of A minus C is an even number. If modulus of A minus C is an even number, then ordered where AC belongs to R. So here, let AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R. Then modulus of A minus B and modulus of B minus C are even numbers. So A minus B and B minus C are even numbers. If A minus B and B minus C are even numbers, then their sum is even number. So A minus B plus B minus C is even number. That is, minus B and plus B cancelled, A minus C is an even number. If A minus C is an even number, then modulus of A minus B is also an even number. If modulus of A minus B is an even number, then ordered where AC belongs to R. So that is, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, implies AC belongs to R for every A comma B comma C belongs to A. Therefore, R is transitive. So now we got R is reflexive, then R is symmetric, and R is transitive. Therefore, R is an equivalence relation. Equivalence relation, because it is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So R is an example for equivalence relation. Now we have one more part here. So here the second part, show that all the elements of set 1, 3, 5 are related to each other. All the elements of set 1, 2, 1, 3, 5 are related to each other, and all the elements of set 2, 4 are related to each other, but no element of set 1, 3, 5 is related to any element of set 2, 4. So here the relation is modulus of A minus B is even number. So we need to show that all the elements of set 1, 3, 5 are related to each other. Modulus of 1 minus 3, modulus of 1 minus 3 is an even number. Modulus of 1 minus 5, even number. 1 minus 3, 1 minus 5, 3 minus 1, then 3 minus 5, then 1 minus 1, 3 minus 3, 5 minus 5, etc. are even numbers. Therefore, we can say all the elements of set 1, 3, 5 are related to each other, because 1 minus 3 is an even number. So, ordered where 1, 3. 1 and 3 are related because A minus B is an even number. So, ordered where AB. 1 minus 5, 3 minus 1, 3 minus 5, 5 minus 1, 5 minus 3, 5 minus 3, not written here, 5 minus 5, and then 5 minus 3, etc. are even numbers. So, all the elements of set 1, 3, 5 are related to each other. Similarly, all the elements of set 2, 4 are related to each other. Modulus of 2 minus 4, modulus of 4 minus 2, modulus of 2 minus 2, modulus of 4 minus 4. They are all even numbers, so they are also related to each other. But no element of this set is related to second set, because modulus of 1 minus 2, modulus of 1 minus 2 is 1. 1 is not an even number. 1 minus 4, modulus of 1 minus 4, that is 3. 3 is an odd number, it's not even number. 3 minus 2, not even number. 3 minus 4, not even number. Modulus of 5 minus 2 is not an even number. Modulus of 5 minus 4, not an even number. Therefore, we can say no element of set 1, 3, 5 related to any element of set 2, 4. So, we can write this step. So, you can write by yourself the reason you will write no element of set 1, 3, 5 related to any element of set 2, 4. The reason, the modulus of their difference is not even number. Now we will do question number 9. We can do the same way. And 10th question, give an example of a relation. Symmetric, neither reflexive nor transitive. So we can give examples. Then 11th, 12th. Question number 11 and 12 almost the same. So I will explain question number 12. Here show that relation R defined in set A of all triangles, set of triangles, and the relation R is given, ordered where T1, T2, such that T1 is similar to T2. This is similar symbol. T1, T2, ordered where T1, T2, such that T1 is similar to T2. If T1 is similar to T2, then ordered where T1, T2 belongs to that relation. And here A is set of all triangles. Then we need to show that this relation is equivalence relation. That means we are going to prove it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Then one more part is there. So we can show that it is equivalence relation for reflexive. T1 related to T1, because a triangle is similar to itself, therefore T1 related to T1. Therefore, ordered where T1 belongs to R for every T1 belongs to set A. So, when we take any triangle from set of triangles, that triangle is related to the same triangle, because a triangle is similar to itself. Therefore, ordered where T1 belongs to R for every T1 belongs to A. So, we can say R is reflexive. Then for symmetric, let T1, T2 belongs to R, implies T1 is similar to T2. If T1, T2 belongs to R, then T1 is similar to T2. Implies if T1 is similar to T2, then T2 similar to T1. If T1 similar to T2, then T2 is similar to T1. Implies ordered where T2, T1 belongs to R. That is, T1, T2 belongs to R, implies T2, T1 belongs to R for every T1, T2 belongs to set of triangles. therefore R is symmetric. Now we have to show that it is transitive. For transitive, let T1 comma T2 belongs to R and T2 comma T3 belongs to R. Transitive property: if ordered pair AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, then AC should be an element of R. So here T1 T2 belongs to R and T2 T3 belongs to R. T1 T2 belongs to R implies T1 similar to T2, and T2 T3 belongs to R implies T2 similar to T3. If T1 similar to T2 and T2 similar to T3, then we can easily say that T1 is similar to T3. T1 is similar to T2. Similar means same shape but different. Same shape but the size can be different. So if T1 and T2, if they have same shape, and T2 and T3 have same shape, then T1 and T3 will have same shape. So we can say therefore T1 is similar to T3. Implies T1 comma T3 belongs to R. That is T1 T2 belongs to R and T2 comma T3 belongs to R implies T1 comma T3 belongs to R for every T1 T2 T3 belongs to the given set here. Therefore R is transitive. Therefore, R is transitive. So now we got R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So R is an equivalence relation. Therefore, R is equivalence relation because it is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. And here we have one more part. Consider three triangles T1 with the sides 3, 4, 5. So we have three triangles. T1 with the sides T1 with the sides 3, 4, 5 and T2 with the sides 5, 12 and 13 and T3 with the sides 6, 8 and 10. Which triangles among T1, T2, T3 are related? So here the relation is similar. So we have to check with which triangles are similar. T1 is similar to T2 or T2 is similar to T3 or T1 is similar to T3. If two triangles are similar, then the ratio between their corresponding sides are equal. So in class 10 we learned. So we can find the ratio between their corresponding sides. So if we compare T1 and T2, ratios are 3 upon 5 not equal to 4 by 12. 4 by 12 is 1 by 3. 3 by 5 and 1 by 3 are not equal. But when we compare T1 and T3, 3 upon 5, 3 upon 6, that is 1 by 2, 3 by 6, 1 by 2, 4 by 8, that is also 1 by 2, 5 by 10, that is also 1 by 2. So here ratio between the corresponding sides are same, therefore we can say T1 is similar to T3, T1 and T3 are similar, or T3 similar to T1. So, but T1 is not similar to T2 and T2 is not similar to T3, but T1 is similar to T3. So that is the relation between them. Then, 13th question show that the relation R defined in set A of all polygons P1 and P2 have same number of sides. So same type of question, we can show that it is equivalence relation. So we need to write some steps, but the method is same, so you can do by yourself. Now we can do question number 14. That is also almost the same, but I will explain. Let L be the set of all lines in XY plane and R be the relation in L defined as. Now we are going to do question number 14. L be the set of all lines in xy plane. L set of all lines in xy plane. That is the given setup. And R be the relation in L defined by ordered pair L1, L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2. So R is given, ordered pair L1, L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2. So this is the relation and this is the set. This relation defined in this set. So relation in this set, that relation is L1 parallel to L2. If L1 is parallel to L2, ordered pair L1, L2 belongs to R. And here L is set of all lines in XY plane. Now we are going to show that R is an equivalence relation. Find the set of all lines related to Y is equal to 2X plus 4. So first we have to show that it is equivalence relation for reflexive. L1 parallel to L1. A line is parallel to itself. L1 parallel to L1. Therefore, ordered pair L1, L1 belongs to R. If L1 parallel to L2, ordered pair L1, L2 belongs to R. Here L1 parallel to L1, therefore ordered pair L1, L1 belongs to R. For every L1 belongs to this sector L. Therefore, R is reflexive. The next, for symmetric. Let L1, L2, ordered where L1, L2 belongs to R. Then if we can show that L2, L1 belongs to R, then it will be symmetric. L1, L2 belongs to R implies L1 is parallel to L2. By the relation L1 is parallel to L2 implies if L1 is parallel to L2, then L2 is parallel to L1. L1 is parallel to L2, then we can easily say L2 is parallel to L1. If L2 is parallel to L1, then ordered pair L2, L1 belongs to R. So here L1, L2 belongs to R implies L2, L1 belongs to R. For every L1, L2 belongs to L. That is L1, L2 belongs to R implies L2, L1 belongs to R. For every L1, L2 belongs to set of all lines in XY plane. Therefore, R is symmetric. R is symmetric. Now we are going to show that transitive. For transitive, let L1, L2 belongs to R and L2, L3 belongs to R. If L1, L2 belongs to R and L2, L3 belongs to R, then if we can prove L1, L3 belongs to R, then it will be transitive. So here L1, L2 belongs to R implies L1 is parallel to L2. And L2, L3 belongs to R, that is L2 is parallel to L3, implies L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. So here L1 and L3 are parallel to the same line, so they parallel to each other. So we can say that L1 is parallel to L3. L1 and L3 are parallel to the same line L2, therefore they are parallel to each other. So L1 is parallel to L3. If L1 is parallel to L3, then ordered pair L1, L3 belongs to R. So ordered pair L1, L3 belongs to R. That is L1, L2 belongs to R and L2, L3 belongs to R implies L1, L3 belongs to R for every L1, L2, L3 belongs to the given set L. Therefore, relation R is equivalence relation, transitive. And here it is symmetric, here it is reflexive. So here it is reflexive, Here this reflexive, symmetric and transitive, therefore R is equivalence relation. R is equivalence relation. Then we have one more part, that is show that R is an equivalence relation. Find the set of all lines related to the line y is equal to 2x plus 4. Y is equal to 2x plus 4. So we need to find a set of all lines related to this line. So the relation is parallel, is parallel. That is the relation. So we have to find a set of all lines parallel to this one. So if two lines are parallel to each other, then a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. In 10th standard we studied, or in 11th we studied another formula, parallel lines ax plus by plus c and ax plus by plus c1 and c2. If the constants are different, then they are parallel to each other. So here set of lines parallel to y is equal to 2x plus 4. Set of lines parallel to y is equal to 2x plus 4 is y is equal to 2x plus, in the place of 4 we can write another constant k, where k is a real number. So here a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. So here these two lines are parallel lines, and here k can be any real number. So here we proved this relation is equivalence relation because it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. And here we got set of all lines parallel to this one, that is y is equal to 2x plus k. So we have done almost all the different and difficult questions. Rest of the questions you can do by yourself.